All right, hello again. This is Marcus Painter with another Quick Tips for Success. This is the show where we encourage entrepreneurship by sharing success principles to help you reach your goals in life. Today, I want to talk about one of the very first real estate deals I did way back in 2008. Now, I was going through some huge changes in my life back then, and I knew that real estate was something that I wanted to do, but I really had no idea how to go about doing it. I was reading a couple different books at the time, and I had gone to a couple free real estate seminars. I even bought Carlton Sheets' course, How to Buy Real Estate with No Money and No Credit. And I thought, wow, man, that's how I can buy real estate right now, because I've got no money and no credit. I remember that the course was on cassette tape, and I think I even had to go out and buy a cassette player because all I had was a CD player. That's how old the course was. Some friends and I ended up buying some education through Rich Dad. It was a very exciting time. We were so pumped about real estate, we just wanted to get out there and find those motivated sellers and put a deal together, even though we didn't know what we were doing. So we did exactly what they told us to do in our education, even though we didn't have all the pieces of the puzzle together. One of the big questions that I had is, why would anybody want to sell me a house at a deeply discounted price? I just couldn't see how anybody could sell a house for 50 cents on the dollar when they should be able to get more for it. So we started putting out bandit signs. We made up our own business cards and passed them out to all our friends and family and everybody we knew. We even did the ugly We Buy Houses car magnets. You know, the ones you put on your car and you drive around town and you hope that nobody you know sees you driving around in it. We started networking with other real estate investors and really just working our business to the best of our ability. Well, pretty soon, the seller leads started coming in. It was so cool to see those first few leads coming in and all of our hard work and effort start to pay off. My wife had bought me an index filing box so I could track all of the leads that I had coming in. Well, I remember talking to this particular seller one day, and we were just going over the basic stuff about her house. You know, how many bedrooms, how many baths, and I think it was a two-bedroom, one bath. It had a one-car garage, and it just needed some TLC. I mean, it was literally just move-in ready, and maybe you could paint some walls. Well, I remember thinking, man, if I could get this house for $5,000 or $6,000, I could probably just mark it up a few thousand and sell it pretty quick and make some money on it. Well, out of the blue, the seller goes, you know what? I don't even think the house is worth $2,500. And that just, it blew my mind. I instantly knew that I had a deal on my hands, and I go, I'll take it. When do we want to sign the paperwork? So I met up with her at Starbucks in the next couple of days, and I remember driving out there. I had all these fears and doubts and worries in my mind about, you know, what if you fill the contract out wrong, or what if you can't find a buyer for the house? I can remember when we were filling the contract out, I was literally so nervous that my hands were shaking. Even though it was a $2,500 deal, it was a big deal to me, and I was way out of my comfort zone. But despite all my fear and anxiety, we got the contract signed, got it all done. I ended up finding a buyer for the house in about a week, and I sold the house in less than 2 weeks for $5,000. So on my first deal, I made a $2,500 assignment fee, which is not too bad for your first deal. I was so excited. I remember I made a photocopy of the check, and I was showing it to all my friends and family and saying, hey, you know what? This real estate thing really does work. And it was really cool to get that first check. Now, there are a couple different success principles that I followed in this little scenario. Even though I really didn't know what I was doing, I did them by accident because I wanted to succeed so bad. The first thing is, I had a desire. I had a burning desire to do real estate. I didn't necessarily know how I was going to do it. I just knew that somehow I wanted to buy and sell houses. The second one is, I took action. You know, even though I didn't have a clear vision of how to do it, I did little things every day, like read a book or networking with real estate investors that had already bought a house and could give me tips. Those little steps every day got me to where I was sitting in front of a motivated seller signing a contract. And the third thing I did is I pushed past my fear. Honestly, I had a lot of fear and anxiety. It was, like I said before, I was just way out of my comfort zone. But I pushed through all that, got the contract signed, we did the deal. I ended up making a little bit of money on it. I helped that lady out because she needed to sell the house so she could move her mom in with her because of medical reasons, and it ended up just being a good deal for everybody. So I guess the whole point of this story is, if you have a desire, you don't necessarily have to see how you're going to do it. every step of the way. You don't necessarily have to see all the pieces of the puzzle lined up when you start. You just need to know what your desire is and then take little action steps every day to make sure that desire comes true. And then persist. You know, it would have been so easy for me to give up and after I called 15 people back and every one of them had laughed at me or couldn't sell their house at the price that I wanted to, I could have walked away, but I didn't. I kept looking until I found what I was looking for. And then finally, push past your fear. You know, anything worth achieving in life is going to cause some anxiety. There's going to be some scary stuff that you're going to have to do along the way. But if you can push past that fear, you'll get much farther than most people do in their life. All right, guys, that's all the time I have right now. Thanks for watching the video. Please give me a thumbs up and favorite this video. Leave a comment. I want to know what you guys have to say. I want to know what you're thinking. I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot.